Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I am going to discuss the anatomy of the pharynx. So what should you know about it? First, what is the length and the location, the extent and the relations, the three divisions, nasopharynx, oropharynx and the laryngopharynx, then the wall and the muscles, three constrictor and the three longitudinal muscles, then the arterial supply and the venous drainage, nerve supply and lymph drainage. Start by the length. It is about 5 inches long. It is located in front of the upper 6 cervical vertebrae. It extends from the base of the skull till C6 and actually till the lower border of the cricoid cartilage, where it continues as the esophagus. Then the relations. What is anterior, what is posterior, and what is on each side? So anterior relation, three cavities, nasal cavity, oral cavity, and the larynx. Posterior, the upper 6 cervical vertebrae. And then on each side, styloid process and structures attached to it. Actually, there are 5 structures, 3 muscles and 2 ligaments. Then nerve vessels, 3 carotid arteries and the internal jugular vein, and then nerves, the last 4 cranial nerves and the sympathetic chain. Okay, so structures on each side of the pharynx. Number 1, styloid process and the structures attached to it. 5 structures, 3 muscles. This is the first one, stylopharyngeus. And then styloglossus. And this one is stylohyoid muscle. 2 ligaments. This is the stylohyoid ligament and the stylomandibular ligament. So styloid process and the 5 structures attached to it. 3 muscles and 2 ligaments. The 3 muscles, stylopharyngeus, this one, styloglossus and the stylohyoid muscle. The 2 ligaments, stylohyoid ligament and the stylomandibular ligament. Then carotid arteries and the internal jugular vein. 3 carotid arteries, common carotid artery, internal carotid and external carotid arteries, and the internal jugular vein, and the last 4 cranial nerves and the sympathetic chain. Okay. The pharynx is divided into 3 divisions. The first part, this one is the nasopharynx, and it is located behind the nose. So nasopharynx behind the nose. Second one, oropharynx. Oropharynx behind the oral cavity, and this is the tongue. Okay? And the third division is the laryngopharynx behind the larynx. So 3 divisions, nasopharynx behind the nose, oropharynx behind the oral cavity, laryngopharynx behind the larynx. Again, the 3 divisions, this is the first division, nasopharynx behind the nasal cavity. Second division, oropharynx behind the oral cavity, behind the tongue. This is the dorsum of the tongue. Okay? and the laryngopharynx, behind the larynx. And then, at the lower border of the cricoid cartilage, it continues as the esophagus. Again, the three divisions. First division, this is the nasopharynx, behind the nasal cavity. And you can see the nasal conchae and the nasal septum. This is the middle concha, and this is the inferior concha. Then the oropharynx, behind the tongue. This is the tongue. And then the laryngopharynx, behind the larynx. And then it continues as the esophagus. Then we'll describe the nasopharynx and the oropharynx. Nasopharynx. What are the features in the nasopharynx? This is the first feature in the roof and the posterior wall. It is the adenoid. Adenoid or pharyngeal tonsil or nasopharyngeal tonsil. So the first feature in the nasopharynx is the adenoid or the pharyngeal tonsil. It is related anteriorly to the posterior nasal orifice, and the floor is formed of the soft palate. This is the soft palate. Anteriorly, it is the posterior nasal orifice, and this is the lateral wall. The lateral wall contains this opening, the opening of the auditory tube, or the opening of the eustachian tube. Then this is the tubal elevation. Tubal elevation is formed by the cartilage of the tube. And then this fold, salpingopharyngeal fold, and this salpingopharyngeal fold is formed by salpingopharyngeous muscle. And then this recess is called the pharyngeal recess. So what are the features in the nasopharynx? Number one, the roof and the posterior wall, collection of lymphoid tissue called the adenoid or pharyngeal tonsil. Inferiorly, it is the soft palate. Anteriorly, it is the posterior nasal orifice. The lateral wall contains opening of the eustachian tube or auditory tube, tubal elevation formed by the cartilage, salpingopharyngeal fold formed by salpingopharyngeous muscle and the pharyngeal recess. This is the oropharynx. The oropharynx contains this lymphoid tissue. This is the palatine tonsil. Okay, so palatine tonsil. Palatine tonsil is related anteriorly to this fold. This fold is called palatoglossal fold. It contains palatoglossus muscle. Posteriorly, this another fold, palatopharyngeal fold, containing palatopharyngeous muscle. So the oropharynx contains the three features: palatine tonsil in the tonsillar fossa, in front palatoglossal arch, posterior palatopharyngeal arch. So let us talk about the palatine tonsil. This is the palatine tonsil. What is the location? Where is it? It is located in the tonsillar fossa. This is the tonsillar fossa. Okay? Tonsillar fossa. This tonsillar fossa is bounded by anteriorly palatoglossal arch containing this muscle, palatoglossus muscle. This is the palatoglossal arch. Posteriorly, palatopharyngeal arch containing palatopharyngeous muscle. This is the palatopharyngeous muscle. So palatoglossal arch anterior, palatopharyngeal arch posterior, and the floor, this is the floor or the bed. It is formed by superior constrictor muscle. This is the superior constrictor. So the tonsil is present in the tonsillar fossa, bounded anteriorly by the palatoglossal arch, posteriorly by the palatopharyngeal arch, and the floor is formed by the superior constrictor muscle. How about the arterial supply? It is supplied by 5 arteries. It is rich in blood supply. 2 from the facial artery. The first one is the tonsillar branch, and this is the main arterial supply to the tonsil. So tonsillar branch of the facial artery. Another branch from the facial artery, the ascending palatine artery. And the ascending palatine artery gives a tonsillar branch. So the first 2 arteries supplying the tonsil, tonsillar branch of the facial artery, and the tonsillar branch of the ascending palatine artery, which is a branch from the facial artery. Then branch from the external carotid artery, which is the ascending pharyngeal artery. Ascending pharyngeal artery. Then the lingual artery. Lingual artery gives dorsal lingual arteries, and then 2 palatine arteries. Lesser palatine artery arising from the greater palatine artery. So the 5 arteries: tonsillar branch of the facial artery, ascending palatine branch of the facial artery, ascending pharyngeal from the external carotid, dorsal lingual arteries from the lingual artery, and the lesser palatine artery from the greater palatine artery. How about the nerve supply? Nerve supply, glossopharyngeal nerve. Yes, this is the glossopharyngeal nerve, and this is the tonsillar branch of the glossopharyngeal nerve. And the other branch is the other nerve is the lesser palatine nerve. So the tonsil is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve and the lesser palatine nerve. How about the lymph drainage? Lymph drainage, upper deep cervical lymph nodes, which are called jugulo-digastric lymph nodes. So the palatine tonsil, present in the tonsillar fossa, between palatoglossal arch anterior and the palatopharyngeal arch posterior, and the bed, the floor, is formed by superior constrictor. It is supplied by 5 arteries, tonsillar branch from the facial artery, ascending palatine branch of the facial artery, ascending pharyngeal from the external carotid artery, dorsal lingual arteries from the lingual artery, and the lesser palatine artery from the greater palatine artery. Nerve supply, glossopharyngeal nerve and the lesser palatine nerve. Lymph drainage, upper deep cervical or jugulo-digastric lymph nodes. This is the tonsillar fossa. Tonsillar fossa is bounded by anteriorly this arch or this muscle, palatoglossal arch. So palatoglossal arch containing palatoglossus muscle anterior. Posterior, this one, palatopharyngeal arch containing palatopharyngeous muscle, posterior. And the floor, this is the floor pierced by many arteries. The floor is the superior constrictor muscle. This is acute follicular tonsillitis. This is the palatine tonsil, inflamed palatine tonsil. This is the palatoglossal arch in front, and this is the palatopharyngeal arch behind. Palatopharyngeal arch and the palatoglossal arch. This is the uvula, okay? So this is the palatine tonsil in the tonsillar fossa behind the palatoglossal arch in front of the palatopharyngeal arch. Regarding the laryngopharynx, this is the laryngopharynx. It contains this inlet, laryngeal inlet. This laryngeal inlet, it communicates the pharynx with the larynx. Okay? Pharyngeal cavity with the laryngeal cavity. It is bounded anteriorly by the epiglottis. This is the epiglottis anterior. Posteriorly, it is bounded by arytenoid cartilage and interarytenoid fold. This is arytenoid cartilage and this is interarytenoid fold. On each side, this fold is called the aryepiglottic fold. Aryepiglottic fold. So the first feature is the laryngeal inlet. The second feature is this fossa. This fossa is called the pyriform fossa. Pyriform fossa is present on each side, is present lateral to the aryepiglottic fold. Okay, now let us talk about the wall of the pharynx. Regarding the wall of the pharynx, it is formed of four layers. FM, FM, fascia, muscle, fascia, mucous membrane, from outside inwards. The outer layer is fascia, is the bucco pharyngeal fascia. So, bucco pharyngeal fascia on outside, followed by the muscle layer, followed by another fascia, pharyngeal basilar fascia, and followed by the mucous membrane. So the outer layer is the bucco pharyngeal fascia, and the inner layer is the mucous membrane. So the four layers from outside: bucco pharyngeal fascia, muscle layer, pharyngeal basilar fascia, and the mucous membrane. What are the muscles of the pharynx? Six muscles. The six muscles are three constrictor muscles and three longitudinal muscles. The three constrictor muscles: superior constrictor, middle constrictor, and inferior constrictor muscle. So three constrictor, superior, middle, and inferior. Three longitudinal muscles. This is the first one, stylopharyngeus. This is the second one, from the soft palate to the pharynx. Palate, pharynx, palatopharyngeus. And this one, from the eustachian tube to the pharynx, salpingopharyngeus. So the three longitudinal muscles, stylopharyngeus, palato from the palate, palatopharyngeus, and salpingo from the tube, salpingopharyngeus muscle. Okay, regarding the constrictor muscles, superior, middle, and inferior, what is the origin and insertion? Superior constrictor, it arises from pterygoid hamulus. This is the pterygoid hamulus. Okay, followed by trigomandibular ligament, followed by the myelohyoid line of the mandible. So superior constrictor takes origin from pterygoid hamulus, trigomandibular ligament, and myelohyoid line. The middle constrictor arises from this ligament, stylohyoid ligament, and the hyoid bone. This is the hyoid bone. Inferior constrictor arises from this cartilage of the larynx. This is the thyroid cartilage, or the oblique line or oblique ridge of thyroid cartilage. And this is the cricoid cartilage. And this tendinous arch, this tendinous arch over the cricothyroid muscle. So again, the origin of the three constrictor muscles: superior constrictor, pterygoid hamulus, تريكو مانديبولر ليجامنت، مايلو هايويد لاين، ميدل كونستريكتور، ستايلو هايويد ليجامنت، هايويد بون، انفيرير كونستريكتور، سيرويد كارتليج، كرايكويد كارتليج، and this arch over cricothyroid muscle. How about the insertion? The three muscles are inserted into a median raphe. This median raphe extends from the pharyngeal tubercle, this is the pharyngeal tubercle, to the cricoid cartilage. Regarding the three longitudinal muscles, this is the first one, stylopharyngeus. From the name, stylopharyngeus, from the styloid process, okay, to the pharynx. This is the second one. It arises from the palatine aponeurosis, arises from the palate. So it's called the palatopharyngeus. From the palatine aponeurosis. This one arises from the Eustachian tube. Okay, so it's called the salpingopharyngeus. Okay, so from the cartilage of the Eustachian tube. So the three muscles. Stylopharyngeus from the styloid process. Palatopharyngeus from the palatine aponeurosis. Salpingopharyngeus from the Eustachian tube, from the cartilage. The three muscles are inserted into the lamina, the posterior border of the lamina of the thyroid cartilage. This is the thyroid cartilage, and the insertion is into the posterior border of the lamina of the thyroid cartilage. And the action is elevation of the pharynx and the larynx during swallowing. There are gaps, spaces between the muscles. So what are the gaps in the lateral wall? Actually, these gaps are closed by the buccopharyngeal fascia. The first gap is above the superior constrictor. This gap between the skull and the superior constrictor. So above the superior constrictor, this is the first gap. Second gap between the superior and the middle. Third gap between the middle and the inferior. And the last one below the inferior constrictor. Okay, above the superior constrictor, we have three structures. First one, this is the cartilage. This is the Eustachian tube, auditory tube, the cartilaginous part. Then two muscles. Yes, I see two muscles. These two muscles are tensor palati and elevator palati. And then two arteries. I see two arteries. These two arteries are ascending palatine artery and ascending branch or pharyngeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. So what are the structures in the first gap above the superior constrictor? Cartilage of the auditory tube, two muscles, tensor palati, levator palati, and two arteries, ascending palatine and the pharyngeal branch. This is the ascending palatine and pharyngeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. Between the superior constrictor and the middle constrictor, three structures. The first one is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Second one is this muscle, stylopharyngeus. And third one, this ligament, stylohyoid ligament. So between the superior constrictor and the middle constrictor, nerve, muscle, and the ligament. The nerve is the glossopharyngeal nerve. The muscle is the stylopharyngeus, and the ligament is the stylohyoid. Then between the middle constrictor and the inferior constrictor, this is the cirrhohyoid membrane. This cirrhohyoid membrane is pierced by nerve and the artery. The nerve is the internal laryngeal nerve, and the artery is the superior laryngeal artery. Below the inferior constrictor, another nerve and artery. This is the recurrent laryngeal nerve, okay? This is the recurrent laryngeal nerve, and this is the inferior laryngeal artery. So again, the gaps in the lateral wall of the pharynx actually are closed by the buccopharyngeal fascia. But the gap above the superior constrictor contains auditory tube, the cartilaginous part, two muscles, tensor palati, levator palati, two arteries, ascending palatine, and pharyngeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. Between superior constrictor and the middle constrictor, nerve, glossopharyngeal, muscle, stylopharyngeus, ligament, stylohyoid ligament. Between middle and the inferior, cirrhohyoid membrane, pierced by internal laryngeal nerve and superior laryngeal artery. Below the inferior constrictor, recurrent laryngeal nerve and the inferior laryngeal artery. What is the arterial supply of the pharynx? Arterial supply of the pharynx. Number one, two pharyngeal arteries, two branches from the facial artery, two palatine arteries, and the two dorsal lingual arteries. So actually eight arteries. So eight arteries are supplying the pharynx. Two pharyngeal, two from the facial artery, two palatine arteries, and the two dorsal lingual arteries. Two pharyngeal arteries, ascending pharyngeal artery from the external carotid artery. Yes, this is the ascending pharyngeal artery. Ascending pharyngeal artery, this one. Ascending pharyngeal artery, okay? And pharyngeal branch from the maxillary artery. This is the maxillary artery. It gives the pharyngeal branch. So two pharyngeal arteries, ascending pharyngeal from the external carotid, okay, this one, and the pharyngeal branch from the maxillary artery. Two from the facial artery, yes, these two. This is the facial artery. The first one is the tonsillar artery. This is the tonsillar artery piercing the superior constrictor. And the second one, this one, is the ascending palatine artery. This one, ascending palatine. Tonsillar artery and ascending palatine. Two palatine arteries from the maxillary artery, lesser palatine and the greater palatine. And two dorsal lingual arteries from the lingual artery. So the pharynx is supplied by eight arteries. How about the venous drainage? Venous drainage, pharyngeal veins, these pharyngeal veins drain into the internal jugular vein. How about the nerve supply of the pharynx? The pharynx is supplied by motor, sensory, and sympathetic. The motor nerve supply is the yellow one, the vagus, except one muscle. So all the muscles of the pharynx, all the muscles of the pharynx are supplied by the pharyngeal branch of the vagus, this one, except the stylopharyngeous muscle, which is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. So all muscles of the pharynx are supplied by pharyngeal branch of the vagus, except the stylopharyngeous muscle, which is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Okay. How about the sensory? Remember, the three divisions. The nasopharynx is supplied by the maxillary nerve through the pharyngeal branch of the sphenopalatine ganglion. The oropharynx is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve through the pharyngeal branch and the pharyngeal plexus. The laryngopharynx is supplied by the vagus, the internal laryngeal nerve. So the sensory innervation of the pharynx. Nasopharynx, maxillary nerve, sphenopalatine ganglion, pharyngeal branch. Oropharynx, glossopharyngeal nerve, pharyngeal branch. laryngopharynx, internal laryngeal branch of the vagus, and the sympathetic innervation to the blood vessels from the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion through the pharyngeal plexus. So regarding the pharyngeal plexus, where is the pharyngeal plexus? The pharyngeal plexus is present on the outer surface of the pharynx. So it is present on the outer surface of the bucco pharyngeal fascia, because the bucco pharyngeal fascia is the outer layer of the wall of the pharynx. What are the roots and what is the distribution? Pharyngeal plexus is formed of three roots. The first one is motor root. Second one is sensory root. And the third one is sensory root, sympathetic. The motor root is from the vagus nerve through the pharyngeal branch. Sensory root from the glossopharyngeal nerve through the pharyngeal branch. Sympathetic root, superior cervical sympathetic ganglion through the pharyngeal branch. So motor root, pharyngeal branch of the vagus. Sensory root, pharyngeal branch of the glossopharyngeal nerve. Sympathetic root from pharyngeal branch of the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. What is the distribution of the three roots? The motor root is distributed to two groups of muscles. Muscles of the pharynx except the stylopharyngeus, because the stylopharyngeus is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Muscles of the palate except the tensor palati, because tensor palati is supplied by the mandibular nerve. So the motor root of the pharyngeal plexus is distributed to muscles of the pharynx except the stylopharyngeus, muscles of the palate except the tensor palati. How about the sensory root? Is distributed to the mucous membrane of the oropharynx. I just told you that the nasopharynx is supplied by the maxillary nerve, and the laryngopharynx is supplied by the internal laryngeal branch of the vagus. How about the sympathetic root? Is distributed to the blood vessels. And finally, the lymph drainage of the pharynx. This is the pharynx. What is the lymph drainage? Number one, these groups of lymph nodes, retropharyngeal lymph nodes behind the pharynx. Retropharyngeal lymph nodes behind the pharynx. The lymph nodes along the internal jugular vein, upper and lower deep cervical lymph nodes. So, retropharyngeal lymph nodes, upper and lower deep cervical lymph nodes. Actually, the pharynx is surrounded by a ring of lymphoid tissue called Waldeyer's ring. So what is Waldeyer's ring? Waldeyer's ring is a ring of lymphoid tissue, this ring, okay, around the pharynx. It is formed of four tonsils: pharyngeal tonsil, tubal tonsil, palatine tonsil, and lingual tonsil. Pharyngeal tonsil, adenoid, tubal tonsil, palatine tonsil, and lingual tonsil. So let us talk about Waldeyer's ring. Waldeyer's ring is a ring of lymphoid tissue around the pharynx. It is formed of, this is the first one, adenoid or pharyngeal tonsil is present in the roof of the nasopharynx, followed by tubal tonsil. This tubal tonsil is around the opening of the eustachian tube, followed by palatine tonsil. Palatine tonsil on each side of the oropharynx, followed by the lingual tonsil in the posterior third of the tongue. So pharyngeal tonsil or adenoid, tubal tonsil, palatine tonsil, and lingual tonsil. They are forming Waldir's ring. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.